Well, hello and welcome back to another edition of the Stogie Review Video Review. And just like I mentioned last week, I was planning on doing a Miami cigar product, and I wasn't quite sure which one. Now, by Miami cigar product, I meant distributed by Miami Cigar, not necessarily Miami Cigar's product. And the choices were either going to be a Nestor Miranda Special Selection or the fairly new La Aurora Barrel Aged. And I decided to go with the Barrel Aged. And I did a little bit of research on this cigar. Not a whole lot. I was running short on time, so I cut it short. But the quick rundown is that this particular size I'll be smoking tonight is the number 4. It's a 43 by 5 3/4. The wrapper is what is being called a Corojo Oscuro. It's from the Dominican Republic, as is the binder. And the filler is made up of tobacco from the Dominican Republic and Nicaragua. Now, these are made in the Dominican Republic in the Santiago La Aurora factory. And I think I paid around $6 for this cigar. May have been just a touch over. The MSRP seems to be between 6 and 9 for the various sizes, of which, I guess I have that, but I didn't make note of it. It looks like there were about 4 sizes. Robusto, Churchill, Bellicoso, and number 4. And anyway, the premise of this cigar is that the wrapper is aged in an oak barrel. Now, barrel aging isn't something that's new for La Aurora, from what I understand. I read a short article by Dave Savona from Cigar Aficionado, and he goes on to say that the 1495 line, as well as the Años, both have filler tobacco that have been aged in oak barrels. Now, the aging of the wrapper, on the other hand, is something that's new for La Aurora. And from what I understand, it was the idea of Jose Blanco. Now, Jose decided to just give it a shot and put some wrapper leaf away in a barrel for a year. And a year had gone by, he cracked it open, and it just smelled heavenly, as it was described. Now, the barrel that they're using is an oak barrel which used to hold Dominican rum. And the idea is not to infuse the cigar with this Dominican rum flavor, but to seal everything up real tight and allow the cigars to ferment, you know, within the cask, and just pick up subtle nuances of what's left over in the oak barrel. And that's how the barrel age came to be. Now, there's some discrepancy in how long the leaf is actually left in the barrel. I'm seeing 4 years, and I'm also seeing 5 years. So I'm just going to rough it and say the wrapper leaf is aged 4 to 5 years in a Dominican rum oak barrel. And that about does it for the makeup of the cigar. Told you I didn't do a ton of research like I like to do, but I'm really running short on time. Angled the cap a little bit, but it was fairly easy. I just mangled it just a little bit. I don't want to peel the cap off, but at the same time, I don't. Now, I've had probably half a dozen of these cigars, and this is the first one I've let set in my humidor for a few weeks. I picked this up locally a couple of weeks ago, and the one thing I find, well, I thought these may be problematic in the sense that my local shop keeps their humidity raised up a little bit, and it's totally understandable due to the fact that it's a walk-in and kind of people are constantly going in and out. So you would expect the humidity to be raised up a little bit to maintain a usable level for when this door goes open and closed. But I assume that's where the stiff draw was coming from in those cigars, which is why I let this one sit a couple of weeks. But I'm having the draw is fairly firm on this one as well. It doesn't seem like the drier environment in my cooler, being 65% relative humidity, did much for the draw. The wrapper is nice and dark. There's a couple of medium-sized veins. They protrude a little bit. It's got a sort of a rustic, a little bit of a rough feel. If you look closely to it, you'll see little tiny little dimples on the wrapper itself. Nice oily sheen to it. The color, there's a little bit of color variation, but I kind of like that. I don't like looking at a cigar and seeing black. A too consistent color. You know, there's some nice variation here. You can see that it's a nice natural product. The color is derived from the fermentation, not from additives or anything like that. Now, being aged in rum barrels, I would expect it to have a little bit of a rum aroma to it, but I'm not really getting that. I'm getting a little bit of a peppery aroma, especially at the foot. And that's about it. So I'm going to go ahead and get this cigar lit and get this review moving. I'm burning for the first third of my La Aurora barrel aged. It's been about 30 minutes now. I've been taking it very nice and slow, and it's been pleasant so far. The ash color has been very light. It's tight, compacted. It's a little flowery now, and that's happened after I've ashed the cigar for the first time. The burn line, it's a little wavy. It's blistering a little bit. I'm getting a little bit of discoloration. The black burn line itself is very oily, shiny. It looks really nice. But the burn line itself is a little lumpy looking and a little discolored. But all in all, I don't think it's affecting the way the cigar is smoking. It's very well behaved, and I haven't run into any trouble spots. Draw is still a little firm for my liking, but I think it has a lot to do with the particular size of this cigar, being a 43 ring, and maybe it being a little overfilled, but I'm not quite sure. Maybe a little bit more time in my humidor would have helped, although a couple of weeks should have allowed it to dry out and acclimate to my preferred relative humidity. The body is about medium. It's leaving a nice film, especially right across the roof of my mouth, right along the palate, and I'm getting a spicy sort of film on the tongue as well. And the finish is fairly creamy. It leaves this almost like a syrupy sort of texture in the mouth. And the flavors are kind of interesting as well. Now, being that this cigar was aged in an old barrel of Dominican rum, I really expected to get a lot of rum flavors, a lot of oak flavors, and things of that nature. I'm not getting any rum flavor that I'm able to pick out. However, I'm getting a lot of oak, and I think this cigar is very distinct and sweet. And I think a lot of that is coming from the wrapper. But, you know, unless I took the wrapper off and smoked the cigar, I'd have no way of knowing whether it was coming from the wrapper or not. Knowing that it was aged in the oak barrel, the wrapper, I would assume that that's where that sweet oak flavor is coming from. It's a little bit much. I am enjoying it, but I just couldn't see myself smoking like one back-to-back. It's a nice cigar, but the impression that I'm getting, at least up until now, is that this certainly wouldn't be one of those cigars that I'd put out and just have a craving for another. It's a nice, satisfying smoke, but in moderation, I suppose. But yeah, I'm getting way ahead of myself. Aside from the sweet oak flavor, I'm not getting a whole lot else. A little bit of spice through the sinus and on the tongue, and that's about it. And what I mean by spice is just a little bit of a bitey feel. I think that about does it for the first third as far as flavor, construction, burning characteristics. Everything's going well. One thing I did want to note was the hat. I want to thank Tony Riccardi from the Monte Cristo room. He felt the need to send me a little care package, which I was not expecting. It came just the other day, and inside were three fantastic cigars, none of which I've had the opportunity to smoke just yet. So they will be my first experience, and this great hat. Now, if you're not familiar with the Monte Cristo room, Tony Riccardi from Cigar Live opened up a private members lounge in New York. A very classy place. Check out the website. Just Google Monte Cristo Room New York, and you should have no problems finding it. But thanks again, Tony. I really appreciate the hat, and try to put it to good use. But for now, that's all I've got. So I'll be back in just a few minutes. We'll do the second, third, and move right along. It's been about an hour overall. Thought I had the cigar go out on me. Anyway, it's been about an hour now, and so far the cigar is doing very well. That thick sort of blistered-looking burn isn't an issue anymore. There's still a little bit of discoloration, but it's not as blistered looking as it was before. The physical burn line is still very dark and shiny. Ash is light in color, it's firm. And that little bit of flaking I got after ashing the cigar the first time was, it must have been a once and done kind of thing. I haven't had that issue come up again. The resting smoke's been light. The room aroma is fairly heavy, but it's pleasant at the same time. I don't know that a non-smoker would find it pleasant, but most likely it would be offensive. But to me, in a sealed room or an enclosed room, I'm not having any issue with it. It's not irritating my eyes, my sinuses. It doesn't have that heavy pungent aroma that sort of takes your breath away. It's fairly nice. One of the things that I mentioned earlier that I didn't elaborate on was that these cigars are aged in Dominican rum barrels. Well, what I didn't elaborate on, and what you may not know, is that, I'm assuming, let's put it that way, La Aurora makes their own rum, and I'm assuming they're using their own rum barrels and aging the tobacco in their own leftover rum barrels. They also make beer. The beer, I think, is a Pilsner. It's Presidente. It's very light. It's nice. I tried it once down at a La Aurora event, actually. But I haven't seen the rum anywhere, and I actually did a little bit of research on the web, and I can't seem to find the name of the rum. Now, what I do find is lots of flavored cigars with rum, but nothing on La Aurora's rum. Now, as far as I know, I didn't like scour the box or anything, but The case of beer, the Presidente, I don't think it says La Aurora on it. I don't know whether they have a different name for the brewery or how that works. So the rum may go by a different name. But when I met Jose and was talking to him, he did say that they make their own rum, they have their own beer. And I thought that was kind of interesting. I'd love to actually try it with the cigar and see how it pairs, but I've really never gotten into rum. Don't have any in the house. What I did decide to do was grab the last bit of Macallan Scotch that I had in the house, and see how it paired up. So I know the Scotch has sort of a caramelly sort of flavor, and I think it might coincide with the sweetness of the cigar, and I think they might pair up nicely. But I haven't tried it yet. I'll give it another few minutes. But as you probably noticed by my last comment, was the primary flavors are still this sweet oak flavor, and it's very distinct. It's kind of up front. It hasn't changed much from the first third. Now it is. It seems a little more refined at this point, but the primary flavor or the focus hasn't really gone away from this oak and sweet flavor. Now, just as before, when you let the palate rest for a second, after you expel the smoke and just kind of set the cigar down and give yourself a minute, I get this nice spicy flavor that comes on mostly through the sinuses, not much on the tongue. It's a little bitey on the palate, but aside from that, the cigar tastes clean, tastes nice. The sweetness is a little much, at least for me. It comes through heavier than everything else. Maybe if there were more of a woody flavor or more of that oak flavor to balance things out, I would find it a little more enjoyable. But for right now, I'm getting just a little too much sweetness for my liking. And I don't mean sort of a sugary sweetness. It's something entirely different. I'm picking it up as a sweetness. And it's very distinct and defined. Overall, you know, the cigar has nice depth and complexity. It tastes good. It's burning well. All in all, it's becoming, or it is, a very solid cigar. Now the draw has loosened up just a little bit, not much, but just enough to make a difference. I don't feel like I'm puffing as hard anymore. I'm still getting the same heavy, dense mouthful of smoke that I have the whole way. It's just a little easier to get now. And you know, as I said, it's when it kind of wafts through the room, it's pleasant but a little heavy. But you know, all in all, I'm enjoying it. So with that said, I'm going to stop tripping over my own words and take a quick break. Take a look at some photos of the La Aurora Barrel Aged, as well as listen to a little music courtesy of PodSafe Music Network. And I'll be back. We'll do the final third and we'll wrap things up. Well, it's about that time to wrap up my La Aurora Barrel Aged. And it's been roughly an hour and a half now. And you know, the general disclaimer applies. If you take my smoke rate and divide it by two, you'll most likely get a realistic smoking rate for the rest of the world. Just like I say many other times, when I do these reviews, the cigar spends a lot of time in the ashtray. One, to keep it cool, and two, so I can jot down lots of notes in between puffs. So don't take that hour and a half smoke rate as the final word. I'm sure you're going to get a much faster rate. Now, given that, I think this cigar burned very well. I mean, I still got quite a bit of cigar left that I do plan on smoking after the camera turns off. For me, the cigar seemed to burn slow. I really felt as though I got my money's worth out of the burn rate of the cigar. It didn't go by fast. The resting smoke's been fairly light. It lingers around the room a little bit, but as I mentioned before, it's pleasant, a little heavy, but it's enjoyable. The burn has pretty much straightened out. I mean, there's very little waviness to it. I'm not getting much of a discoloration anymore. The burn line's thin. It's dark and crisp. The ash is light in color. It's compacted, firm. You know, it takes a good tap to knock it off the end of the cigar and into the ashtray. I didn't get any flaking or flowering on the keyboard or anything like that. It was just that one incident where I got a little bit of flowering after the first initial ashing. And since then, everything's been very well behaved. As I've been smoking throughout the cigar, the body has slowly been progressing. And it seems to have plateaued in the... it's a good medium, I guess is the best way to put it. It's not quite medium to full, but it's a good, solid, medium-bodied cigar. The finish, I get this this thin sort of film on my palate and tongue and walls of my mouth. It's like a very thin syrup sort of texture almost. Nice flavor, not overwhelming, a little bit of a bite from the spiciness, but overall it's enjoyable. In terms of flavor, I didn't get much of a change throughout the entire cigar. I'm still getting a very defined sweetness and oak flavors, and you know, I started to think about exactly what I was getting, and I sort of second guess myself a lot when I do these reviews off camera, and it's definitely not a Corojo flavor that I traditionally enjoy. I guess I should rephrase that a little differently. It doesn't taste like that traditional Corojo flavor that I really enjoy. From time to time, that Corojo flavor does pop in, and I really enjoy that. But just as quickly as it pops in, it fades back out. Now, the sweetness and the oak flavors do get more defined, and they get richer as I go. But really, the cigar hasn't changed direction as far as the flavor is concerned. I can only imagine that the sweetness is coming from the wrapper. I think that it may be a byproduct of the rum, and I'm kind of confused as to why I'm not getting a flavor reminiscent of rum throughout the cigar, and it kind of dawned on me that sweetness could possibly be a byproduct of that rum, but again, I'm not really sure. I'm just guessing at this point. And I also expected to get a little bit more of a Corojo flavor, being that the wrapper is Corojo. Now, I did get that occasional flavor pop here and there, but again, I really think that aging the cigar within the oak barrel really made a big change on the way that the Corojo wrapper tastes. And, you know, I enjoyed it. While this cigar isn't one that I can see myself smoking a couple of times a week, I can definitely see myself picking them up from time to time. The sweetness was a little bit much for me. I enjoyed it, but I couldn't smoke this cigar 2, 3, 4 times throughout the week. But, you know, maybe once throughout the week, every other week, you know, I can definitely see myself enjoying it. I had mentioned that I paired it up with a little bit of scotch. And the flavors, they pair well with one another. The sweetness of the cigar and the sort of caramel and almost like a charcoal flavor of the scotch, they complement each other well. But I'd be very interested in trying this cigar with the rum that was in the barrel when it was aged, or before it was, the rum that used to be in the barrel that this was aged in. I'd be very interested in giving that a shot. But I have no idea what the name of the rum is. My Google searches turned up blanks. But you know, I'd really be interested in giving that a shot. I can only imagine that they would pair up very well together. So if anyone knows what the name of the rum that La Aurora produces is, I'd love to hear about it. Please feel free to drop a comment if you know. I'd really appreciate it. Overall, you know, I really enjoyed the cigar. It burned well, nice slow smoke rate, flavors were good. The sweetness was a little bit much for me, but, you know, as I said, I can see myself picking these up from time to time. And I think that maybe if I go to a larger size, something like a Robusto, where I'm getting a little bit more filler than I am with a Corona, I think I might dial back the sweetness. So I'm going to have to give those a shot. The last time I was in my local shop, there were 2 or 3 boxes of barrel aged sitting off into the corner, and I think they might have been the larger sizes. For right now, the only thing that he's got out for purchase is the Corona. So Maybe I'll have to nag him a little bit, and maybe he'll pick up some Robustos, and I'll be able to give those a try and see if the wrapper is where all that sweetness is coming from. And if I can dial it back with a larger ring size, I think I might enjoy the cigar even more so than I am now. But that's what I've got for the week, or yeah, for this week. The Aurora barrel aged. As far as what I'm smoking next week, this is a complete mess. I have a list of cigars that I need to smoke, and I really should be getting two certain ones, but for whatever reason, I end up deciding last minute and rummaging through the cooler trying to find it. Maybe I'll do the. I'll tell you what, I'll either do the Nestor Miranda Special Selection next week, or I'll do something from IPCPR, and I'm going to do it again. I don't know. Either it's going to be the Nestor Miranda Special Selection, or I'll post a comment, or try to post a comment earlier on. If you're that curious, ask, and then I'll be more likely to respond to you and give you an answer. And I'll let you know when I'm smoking next week. But until next week, happy smoking. Oh, and once again, thanks, Tony, for the hat. Really appreciate the hat and the smokes.